A very safe and good morning to all. Looking at important headlines from the Hindu newspaper for 19th March. So Hindu Now has come up with a coverage on jacket page too. So after the advertisement page, on this jacket page, you have coverage on COVID-19. So the first one is the importance of contact tracing. So means whenever somebody is infected, then those who had come in contact with that person would also be infected. So who are these contacts are highlighted here, like the family members, health workers, roommates, visitors, close physical contacts, partners, schoolmates, colleagues with whom the person has come in contact with are contacts. And contact tracing is very important when a case of COVID-19 is detected. So from the second phase, when local transmission takes place, it is an integral part of fighting the epidemic on the ground. So that is why it is said not to travel, not to stay indoors and not to come in contact with many people. So that if a person is infected, at least the infection does not spread. So that's the reason. So here you can see health workers identify, assess and manage people who have been exposed to a disease to prevent onward transmission. Means from one person to another. So this part of their job is called contact tracing. So then the contacts may also be showing symptoms or may not be showing symptoms, still they have to be under watch. So if they are asymptomatic, not showing symptoms, then they are placed under home quarantine. Otherwise they are referred for isolation if they are showing symptoms. And here you have FDA, US Food and Drug Administration, urges virtual patient visits. So it says coronavirus disrupts clinical trials. So clinical trials have been halted to ensure safety of patients now. So that is it. And here it is, are diabetic more prone to COVID-19? So it says precautions are a must as they have immunocompromised state. So anybody who is suffering from any disease is more prone to COVID-19. We have already seen this earlier, you know, in old age and when the immunity system is low. In such cases, COVID-19 is more likely to show symptoms and more likely to attack. Then here you have the effect of coronavirus on the economy. The pandemic, it says, United Nations says, will slash incomes. It could make another 25 million jobless. And here you can see this is a research paper published in New England Journal of Medicine that said that SARS-CoV, that is virus responsible for COVID-19, can linger on some surfaces for hours, though the risk of getting infected reduced with every passing minute. So hours taken for viable virus to reduce to half its initial value and to completely disintegrate is shown here on various surfaces, number of hours it takes. And here this is the effect of virus on US economy. That is fine. And here the highlighting of the main prevention method for COVID-19, to frequently wash your hands and not shake other people's hands. Then on the front page, you have 276 Indians infected with virus abroad. So total cases of COVID-19 in India have touched 162, including 25 foreigners, and global figures are now 2 lakh. So there are Indians abroad who have been infected too, you can see, in Iran and other 21 countries. Then this is regarding Madhya Pradesh political crisis. The Supreme Court is hearing the matter too. BJP approached the Supreme Court and Supreme Court says we are anxious to avoid horse trading in Madhya Pradesh. And it says our duty is to verify on dissident MLAs. The term horse trading also should be understood. Horse trading basically means that when members of a political party from one members from one political party are being lured into another political party. So that is called horse trading. Then here you have, with 2 weeks to census start, uncertainty clouds NPR. So at least 13 states and Delhi have opposed the new format. So whether the census would take place as scheduled to kick off from 1st April or not, we'll have to wait and watch. These 13 states and New Delhi actually comprise 60% of the total population of the country. who have opposed NPR, been updated in the format being prepared by the center in the new format, where date of birth of parents are also being asked. On page 6, you have CAA has made 6 lakh refugees forever stateless. So these are rights group, New Delhi based rights group, which have said that Citizenship Amendment Act 2019 has made 6 lakh refugees in India forever stateless and vulnerable to refoulement. Means they will be sent back, and the country where they would be sent back may not take them back to. So CAA prescribes citizenship for 6 non-Muslim communities which took refuge in India from Afghanistan, Pakistan and Bangladesh till 2014. So the 6 lakh who stand to be excluded are around 3 lakh from Sri Lankan Tamils, are Sri Lankan Tamils, 1 lakh are Tibetans and some 1 lakh Chins from Myanmar, including even 40,000 Rohingyas from Myanmar. And 39,000 others recognized by UN Human Rights Commission for refugees. On the editorial page, the first editorial is competitive impropriety. So this is regarding retired judge accepting a parliament seat. This is about former Chief Justice of India Ranjan Gogoi, who retired in October 2019 to take over Rajya Sabha seat, which was offered by the central government. So it says, the editorial says, retired judges should not accept a parliament seat lest it is seen as a political reward. Justice Ranjan Gogoi was the one who gave his ruling on Ram Janmabhoomi case, to Babri Masjid Ram Janmabhoomi land dispute case. And he had said he wanted to finish that case before his retirement. He had not allowed even delaying the hearings to. Stating so. Then this editorial is Democratic Heft. So this is regarding Joe Biden, the US Democrat candidate. So he seems electable, his seeming electability needs message of socioeconomic equality voiced by Sanders. So there's another person who is Bernie Sanders. He's also contesting the elections from Democrat Party. The US presidential elections are going to take place. So this is regarding these two candidates from Democratic Party. So this is not important for us at all. So you can skip this. And this is in upper house nomination, a fall for aloofness. So this is regarding the same what the first editorial spoke of, the nomination of former Chief Justice of India to Rajya Sabha. It says this is a blow against the judiciary's independence. Then this is time for a powerful display of humanity. So it says in the times of this pandemic of COVID-19, it is easy to apportion blame, that was to be blamed. But this is a moment for the world to be standing together. Then on op-ed page, you have an SC verdict violative of minority rights. So a recent decision of two-judge bench has taken away autonomy of madrasas in West Bengal. So protection of minorities is the hallmark of a civilization. Lord Acton had added another dimension to this when he said the most certain test by which we judge whether a country is really free is the amount of security enjoyed by minorities. So presently here also we have seen in India that the autonomy of madrasas have been taken away in West Bengal. So this is regarding this case. So 2019 judgment. A three-judge bench had given Sikh minority institution of West Bengal right to appoint teachers. And in less than 4 months, the right given to Sikh minority institutions by Apex Court has been denied to Muslim minority religious institutions. On page 13, you have call data being used to improve quality. So this is a statement being given because Department of Telecom has been seeking call data records from telecom companies, and there are questions of possible surveillance and violation of privacy being raised now. So that is why it is saying that this data has been collected only to analyze and improve the quality of telecom services, and says there is no surveillance going on. So this is the assurance given. And this is Nation Needs NRC, Center tells Supreme Court. So Center has informed the Supreme Court that is a necessary exercise to identify citizens from the non-citizens. On international page, you have this coverage on how world grapples with once in a 100 year virulence. So how this virus has affected the globe is shown here. And here you have on the business page how the stocks have been falling, and below you have again how RBI is undertaking open market operations. So RBI has decided to infuse 10,000 crore liquidity in the banking system by buying government securities through open market operations. So this is important. So that is it. These are the important headlines. For detailed coverage of current affairs, you can visit our website, asha.com. Thank you.